For more than 50 years, the P-3 Orion has watched and protected the free world's sea lines. It has an important place in the history of maritime patrol and anti-submarine warfare aircraft. But the time is running out for this iconic seabird. Now, we are investigating the legendary P-3 Orion, the mythological hunter of the seas. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel before we start and give us a thumbs up if you like our video. To be notified of our new video, please click the bell button. Also, now you can click the join button to support our channel. Since 1962, the P-3 Orion has been a busy maritime patrol and anti-submarine warfare aircraft. It has carried out the duty all around the world. But this aircraft is now ready for retirement. Let's look at the brief development history of the aircraft. After the Second World War, Moscow realized that the Soviet Navy could not match the big surface fleet of the West. Also, a large-scale shipbuilding program was not economically possible. The First Cold War was rising and the lion's share of the budget had to be spent to produce jet fighters, modern tanks, and nuclear arsenal. Even if the shipyards built large quantities of surface combatants, the Soviet Navy did not have enough experienced manpower. The USSR could not win an open sea battle. So, Moscow decided to build a pirate navy. The modern pirates were the submarines. The Soviet shipyards began to construct a massive submarine fleet. NATO needed to improve its anti-submarine warfare capacity. The US Navy converted many Essex-class aircraft carriers to anti-submarine warfare carriers. The S-2 tracker aircraft and SH-3 Sea King helicopters would protect the extensive sea lines, but it was not a feasible and reliable solution. Having such a fleet was expensive, and if a carrier were hit or malfunctioned in a possible war, all the aerial vehicles could be rendered ineffective. The land-based long-range maritime patrol and anti-submarine warfare aircraft was a cost-effective and a reliable solution. In the late 1940s, turboprops had reached maturity. They had a greater power-to-weight ratio and reliability compared to piston engines. So, the US Navy wanted to use these advantages. Because the piston engines of the P-2 Neptunes and P-5 Marlins were not as reliable as the turboprops. The crew comfort was crucial for a long-range patrol, but the habitability of these aircraft was low. Also, the Western engineers had developed many new types of submarine detection systems which required more space to be fitted. Neither the Neptune nor Marlin had enough space. So, in 1957, the US Navy required a new turboprop maritime patrol and anti-submarine warfare aircraft to replace its P-2s and P-5s. To answer this requirement, Lockheed modified an L-118 Electra airliner. The US Navy signed a contract with the company in April 1958. The prototype made its first flight on August 19, 1958. The production model of the aircraft, called P-3V1, made its first flight on April 15, 1961. 1 year later, it became operational. Later, the US Navy changed the aircraft designation and renamed the P-3V1 as P-3A Orion. The crew instantly loved the aircraft. The flight characteristics of the P-3 was smooth. It could take off and land from a short distance. The turboprop engines were reliable. Besides, because it was a derivative of an airliner, the P-3 had a larger internal space than the P-2, so the crew could move inside the aircraft without bending. The larger volume also provided more space for additional sophisticated mission equipment. The fuselage, wings, and tail were made of aluminum alloy that were highly resistant to corrosion. The P-3A had two 3,420 kW T-56 A-10W engines. Shortly after, the B variant, which had 3,661 kW T-56 A-14 engines, were introduced. The P-3C made its first maiden flight on September 8, 1968. For the first two variants, the sonobuoys could only be loaded internally. The P-3C sonobuoys could be loaded both internally and externally. In 1976, the C variant gained the capability of launching AGM-84 Harpoon. 1 year later, the aircraft was equipped with an infrared detection system. Besides the maritime patrol and anti-submarine warfare variants, the Orion had numerous models for other missions. For example, the TP-3 was a modified version for training duties. The utility variant of the aircraft was the UP-3. Also, many electronic intelligence models, such as the EP-3 and UP-3D, were produced. The aircraft even had an airborne early warning and control variant. The OP-3C was developed for image information reconnaissance missions. In 1986, Japan, which produced the aircraft under license, even considered modifying the P-3C as a flying air defense cruiser. The aircraft would be equipped with the AN-APS-138 radar of the E-2C and the AN-AWG-9 radar of the F-14. This modified Orion, which could carry 12 AIM-54 Phoenix long-range air-to-air missiles, would protect the fleet from the bombers, which could launch the long-range anti-ship missiles. But later, the project was abandoned. Argentina, Australia, Brazil, Canada, Chile, Germany, Greece, Iran, Japan, New Zealand, Norway, Pakistan, Portugal, South Korea, Spain, Taiwan, and the USA are the current users of the P-3. The Netherlands and Thailand retired them. The crew of the P-3C is 11 person. The aircraft has a length of 35.6 meters, a wingspan of 30.4 meters, a wing area of 120.77 square meters, and a height of 11.8 meters. Its empty weight is 27.98 tons, while its maximum takeoff weight is 64.41 tons. Four 3,661 kilowatt Allison T56 A14 engines provide a maximum speed of 761 kilometers per hour. The cruise speed of the aircraft is 607 kilometers per hour. The range of the P-3C is 8,944 kilometers. Its service ceiling is 8,625 meters. The aircraft can carry AGM-84 Harpoon anti-ship missiles, AGM-65 Maverick air-to-surface missiles, Mark 46, Mark 50, Mark 54, and MU-90 torpedoes, sea mines, and depth charges. With a standard mission payload, the weight of the P-3C was 49,895 kilograms. With this weight, the aircraft could conduct the patrol mission at an altitude of 457 meters with a speed of 381 kilometers per hour for 3 hours. So, the Orion could cover a mission radius of 3,494 kilometers. During the service life, the subsystems of the P-3 have been constantly upgraded. Also, different users replaced the AN-APS-155 radar of the aircraft for more modern ones. In 2008, Lockheed Martin began to produce the new wings for the P-3 as a part of its service life extension program. The Orion's 2.3 meter wide, 0.88 meter deep, and 3.91 meter long internal bomb bay is used for the torpedoes. The aircraft can carry the torpedoes under wing pylons only for ferrying. The standard endurance of the aircraft is 10 to 12 hours. To increase the endurance, the aircraft can shut down its outside left and right engines. This way, the fuel consumption decreases. But it is known that when the engines shut down, the stability is reduced, and the rear part of the aircraft is likely to shake. In 1972, an Orion of the Royal New Zealand Air Force, which was the first foreign customer of the P-3, set a record by using this method and aloft for 21 hours and 30 minutes. When the world came face to face with the threat of nuclear war in 1962, the P-3 was one of the leading players. During the Cuban Missile Crisis, the aircraft took on important tasks in the pursuit of the Soviet ships approaching the blockade area. 2 years later, the Orions began to patrol over Vietnam coasts. In Operation Maritime, they pursued the vessels which carried the supplies to the Viet Cong. The P-3s were generally flying over the sea. Yet, from time to time, they also flew over the land which was a dangerous mission. In 1968, one US Orion was shot down by the Vietnamese anti-aircraft guns. 4 years later after this sad event, this time the P-3 became a part of happy news. On January 28, 1971, by reaching a speed of 806 km per hour, an Orion set a world speed record for heavyweight turboprops. Just before Iraq invaded Kuwait in 1990, the US Navy was testing a specialized over-the-horizon targeting system package on a P-3. This aircraft deployed to the Middle East immediately. At the very beginning of Operation Desert Storm, it detected a big Iraqi fleet near Bubiyan Island. This P-3 directed the strike elements of the coalition to the fleet. The result was devastating for the Iraqis. The Orions were used for numerous valuable surveillance. During the war, 108 Iraqi vessels were destroyed. The US sources claim that 55 of them were targeted by the P-3Cs. The Orion's ground surveillance capabilities were enhanced in the late 1990s. The US and Australian P-3s were frequently used to support ground operations in Afghanistan and Iraq in the 2000s. The P-3 played key roles in many important battles, but its EP-3E Aries II variant has become more mediatic. On April 1, 2001, an EP-3E of the US Navy collided with a Chinese J-82 fighter in the air. For many, this was not an accident. China had sacrificed the aircraft and the pilot to make the Aries II land. Of course, before the emergency landing to Hainan Island, the crew of the EP-3E had destroyed many of the classified materials, hardware, and software on the aircraft as a standard procedure. Even so, it is estimated that the Chinese intelligence managed to reach some critical information. During the 2011 military intervention in Libya, a US Navy P-3C Orion fired an AGM-65 Maverick missile on a Libyan Coast Guard vessel. The vessel was beached after it had tried to escape. In 2007, Pakistan used its P-3s for ground surveillance and bombing missions against the Taliban. So, in 2011, the Taliban raided the headquarters of the Pakistan Naval Air Arm Base in Karachi and managed to destroy two of them. The Pakistani Orions have also been very useful assets for the clashes in the Kashmir region. Since 2008, the German, Japanese, Portuguese, and Spanish P-3s have been used against piracy in Somalia. In Greek mythology, the Orion is the son of Poseidon. Generally, the sons succeed the father. But today, many of its users are replacing their P-3s with the P-8 Poseidon. Also, the Orions of the Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force give their place to the P-1s. Many P-3 users have not decided on the successor of the aircraft, so the Orion will continue its mission for a while. However, the time is running out for the P-3. Since the 1960s, it has protected the sea lines of the free world and become one of the most feared adversaries of the Eastern submarines. Yet, the Orion is now tired. This legendary aircraft deserves a well-earned retirement. It will lose its place in military service soon, but the P-3 will never lose its place in the hearts of aviation enthusiasts. Thanks for watching our video. And please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and give us a thumbs up if you liked our video. To be notified of our new videos, please click the bell button. Also, you can now click the join button to support our channel.